I mean, this is a neighborhood in disbelief. We just talked to a neighbor who said that Esther Salas and her husband, Mark, were wonderful people. Their son, Daniel, just 20 years old, also just a wonderful man who wanted to be a lawyer just like his parents. Now, what we're learning from investigators here, what happened at this home behind me, you can see the crime scene tape still up. From sources, we're learning that a gunman came to the door of this home, the door answered by the judge's son, again, 20-year-old Daniel, his father not far behind him. That gunman wearing a FedEx uniform. It's unclear if it was a disguise or actually a FedEx employee, but opened fire, killing the 20-year-old and injuring the judge's husband, who's now at the hospital. We hear that the judge was home at the time, but unharmed. So a lot of questions here. Of course, motive being the major one. Why did this happen? What are the reasonings? Investigators, including the FBI, U.S. Marshals, looking into that as we speak. We know that, as you guys said, the judge, Esther Salas, she is presided over some really high-profile cases, including the fraud case and sentencing of the Real Housewives, Teresa and Joe Giuducci, a couple of years ago. Also, she was involved with the sentencing of a very notorious gang member in Newark. And most recently, she was handed the case that involved Deutsche Bank and its handling of high-risk clients, including Jeffrey Epstein. So that was a class-action suit with Deutsche Bank. So there are a number of things that investigators are looking into. And again, as I mentioned, her husband as well, a criminal defense attorney. So a lot here that investigators are sifting through, and it's a massive investigation. Neighbors telling us that this son was really the heart of this family. She recalled a story when he delivered chicken soup through the snow a couple doors down just to make sure that the neighbors were well taken care of during a massive snowstorm. Loved playing basketball and baseball with his father. It's just a heartbreaking story, and so many questions still need to be answered.